3D printing, also known as additive manufacturing, used to create a three-dimensional object in which layers of material are formed under computer control to create an object. Objects can be almost any shape or geometry, and typically are produced using digital model data from a 3D model or another electronic data source. 3D printing has many applications in manufacturing, medicine, architecture, and custom art and design, which facilitate 3D printing to become successful commercial technology. This is the Form 2 3D printer, which delivers high resolution prints at a fraction of the cost. The Form 2 enables to print precise models with stunning surface finish and significantly smoother and more detailed than other plastics. The printer uses stereolithography, SLA 3D printing technology, or sometimes called the laser 3D printing technology. The platform dip itself into the resin glass tank, and ultraviolet laser light will shine on it. The resin then cures, solidifies, and sticks to the platform. As more and more layers are being created, after more resin is exposed to the laser light until the entire object is finished. The two left arms are printed in fused deposition modeling (FDM) and stereolithography (SLA), and we can see the difference between them. The hollow on the inside of FDM print has a bit of a scaffolding, which we can see the internal structure. While the SLA print always print in solid form. We can also see that there is hollowing that is smoother and more sandy. In stereolithography SLA post-processing, we need to submerge the printed object in isopropyl alcohol and place it out in the sun to UV cure. Then, remove the support and get rid of the knobs by using knife and sanding block. The layer thickness can reach around 25 microns to 200 microns, which is higher strength than FDM. In fused deposition modeling, FDM post-processing, we can see the printed object coming fresh off the printer bed as a bunch of globbing and stringing. This is often caused by the hot and temperature being too hot, so additional bits are deposited everywhere. Compared to SLA, it remains cool the whole time. To clean up, we can ripping off the extra pieces and use clippers to remove the support material. Then, use knife and sanding block to get rid of the little blocks. The layer thickness can reach around 100 microns to 300 microns. The final model SLA print got a really nice smooth surface, while FDM print is a bit more glossy and it could use a bit more cleanup as well.